Last week we preached a message on the role of a man in the household. This week we are dealing with a woman's role in the household. And I am speaking to men and women who are believers in the Lord, because that's what the Lord is describing in His Word, far as the relationship goes. As two people who are in love with Him. And when they're in love with Him, they can be in love with one another. One of the things when I read the Scriptures I see that God demands is that we find a mate that loves Him. And when we find that mate, we can commit one to the other. And when we stand and take our marriage vows said we'll stick with one another. Through sickness, through health, through riches, or through poor, until death do us part. But how many today say those words and never actually mean those words from the heart? They're just mere words if you don't mean it from the heart. We'll end up in a disaster. In that relationship, when we don't mean those words from the heart. And we can only mean those words from the heart is when we know Jesus Christ as our Lord. Because see, every promise and commitment that God has made to us, He's never broken. And the Bible tells us it's impossible for God to lie. So God wants a relationship with us as believers. And in this relationship is considered a marriage in essence. The Bible declares that all believers are His bride. And if I'm His bride, He's making a commitment to me, just as if we was together here today and have a man and woman before me who's making commitment with one another. God has made that commitment with you and me. He has promised us eternal life if we'll trust Him. If we'll ask for forgiveness of our sins, He gives us eternal life. Eternal life is something to be proud of, because see, in that life that He gives, there's no eternal punishment and no eternal separation from Him. We're stuck. And I believe my favorite singer is Elvis Presley, if you don't know it by now. He sung a song that says, "I'm stuck on you. I'm going to stick like glue because, baby, I'm stuck on you." And God is stuck on us. We should be stuck on each other as God is stuck on us in our relationships with one another. And if we can't do that, friend, then God help us. See, one of the things that the devil is trying to destroy, not only in America but around the world, is the sanctity of marriage. And if he can destroy the family, friend, he can destroy our country, he can destroy our world, and he's doing a great job, because we have allowed it to happen. We have listened to Satan lies, and we've been deceived and thinking that that don't happen any longer. I beg to differ. It'll happen when you purpose in your heart to make it happen. And friend, we need to get back, amen, to good sanctity of marriage and good living. And we need to get back there. And it's not too far gone that we can't get there. We just got to get rid of our sinful ways and quit listening to the enemy who is trying to destroy it. Amen? And God help us. Because see, if he can destroy the family, the devil can destroy the family, he can destroy you as a nation. The family is the backbone of America. Family, coming together and worshiping together, prays together, and stays together. The Word of God teaches us the role of a woman as a believer. Amen? He shares with us in Proverbs this morning, if you have your Bibles, in chapter 31, looking at verse 10. Proverbs, matter of fact, is written by one of the smartest men that ever lived. And that was King Solomon. And reason he was the smartest man, and because he asked for wisdom from God to lead his people. And so he pens the scripture down as the Holy Spirit moved him concerning a virtuous woman. And he says, who can find a virtuous woman? For her price is far, far above rubies. And if we look at that word, virtuous woman, it's a righteous woman. One who loves the Lord. One who trusts in the Lord. And leans not unto her own understanding. But ask wisdom from the Lord to direct her path. She seeks his wisdom. As she seeks it at home. She is priceless, the Bible says here. Her wealth is beyond rubies. So if you're a righteous woman today, in the sight of God, you're priceless. You're priceless. Nothing can measure up to you. Valentine's Day, we couldn't give you enough roses. We couldn't provide a nicer gift because you're far more than anything that we could offer you here on this earth because you love the Lord. You love the Lord. The Bible says in the next verse that a heart of her husband doeth safely trust in her. So that she'll have no need of spoil. She doesn't have to worry about anything. The man that she's married to, he don't have to worry about where she's been sleeping because he knows where she's been sleeping. Are you with me? Why? Because she trusts God and she trusts in her husband. Who has taken up his responsibility, mind you. I'm talking about a couple that are trusting the Lord. He is the head of his household. He is the spiritual leader. And as God has entrusted him with the gift of leading his family, he's shared it with his wife, and then she too shares it with her household. So that trust is built. And if you don't have trust today, then what do you have? You have nothing. Trust. I trust in the Lord because I trust him by faith. And I have to believe in him and in his words that he's said that he will do exactly what he says. And so in our relationship, we have to trust one another in our words and what we say we are and what we're going to do are going to take place, and that's where we'll be. She has to trust in a husband that if he tells her he's working late, she knows he's working late. And he vice versa. If she says she's got to do something, she's got to be in this place or that place, he's got to trust her that she's doing exactly what she's saying. So that trust is built upon God. Upon God. When we build that trust upon God, then we have that trust one with the other. As the writer goes on here, she is in compassion. Reliable, amen. She, as a companion, is reliable to her husband. In verse 12, he states, I might have already read it, but anyhow, we'll do it again. She will do him good and not evil all the days of her life. She is a companion which is reliable. Her heart is always set on the care of her household. If we look at the verses 13 through 19, she seeketh wool and flax and worketh willingly with her hand. She is like the merchant ship. She brings her food from afar. She rises also while it's yet night and giveth meat to her household, a portion to her maiden. She considers a field and she buys it. With the fruit of her hand she planted a vineyard. She girded her loins with strength and strengthened her arms. She perceives that her merchandise is good. And her candle goeth not out by night, and she lieth her hands to the spindle, and her hands holdeth the staff. And my friend, today the Word of God teaches her here that a Christian woman is always, amen, taking care of her household. And how does she do that? She does it by what the man is supplying to the household. You ever heard the saying, the man brings in the bacon, mama cooks it? Huh? But I mean, the man is doing his responsibility, the woman is doing hers. Today, in today's economy, we both have to work, amen, to make the house, amen, whole, amen, functional. But my friend, we work together in unity as the Lord has given us strength. We trust one another. We consider, amen, amen, a great household when God is in the center of it. And we are blessed. She cares for a household. She's got a heart, amen, for a home, for her children, for her husband. I mean, when she sold out in marriage to him, amen, she gave him her heart. And the Bible says, amen, just the way that God planned it in Genesis when he made Eve for Adam, they too became one flesh. Her heart is for her husband and her husband's heart is for her. And for their household, they want their children to be nourished and brought up, amen, in the respect of the Lord Jesus Christ. They want to teach them the right way to go. When they grow old, they'll not depart from it. Her household is important. Her mainly focus is to take care of her household first. Her household is important to her. God takes care of us first, amen? If he can't take care of his own first, then he can't provide for the world who don't know him. Are you with me? So he has to take care of those who know him and come to him, and then he can take care of the world through us as we take care of our own. Hello? Are you with me, ladies? Her heart is always set on the care of her household. She is a companion which is reliable, and she's also a one who has a heart of generosity. As I said, her household is her first concern. And then after her household is provided for, she reaches out to the needy. Look at verse 20. She stretches out her hand to the poor. She reaches forth her hands to the needy. Ladies, I have to give you credit where credit is due. You have a heart to help the needy before man does. And I can vouch for that because Cheryl will help somebody before I will. Are you with me? Y'all have a heart, amen, that man don't have. That's why God put you with us. Because we're stubborn as an old mule. Well, I woke some of you up over here anyhow. I mean, we just don't have the compassion a mother has and a wife has. Hello? Especially a mother. God help us to have a heart like that, guys. I mean, how many of you have raised children? All right, you're going to know what I'm talking about. Because, see, when my children got hurt or sick, they go to mama. Why? Because dad just don't have the heart and patience. Hello? Come on, I'm honest this morning. I mean, I can remember several times, especially with Chris, our son, when he would start playing football as a little bitty fella. And he fell right there on the ground in the first game. And I thought he just, you know, got scared and started crying and holding his arm. I said, "Shake it off, boy, go on." And mama and the coach told me, "I think he broke his arm." I felt this small, you know. But we just don't have the compassion that a mother's heart has. And that's why God gave us a wife, hello? Because he knows we need help. Ladies, he knows we need help. And y'all complete us. That's why he didn't make another man for Adam, hello? He didn't make Steve for him. Them two couldn't done nothing. Hello? Just a thought here, amen. Just run with it. You just think about that for a little while. It'll come to you that he made woman because woman completes man. And that completeness couldn't be found in any other creation. Even though he had a beautiful world in which to live. Though he had animals all around him. And guys, dog don't take the place of your wife. I love my dog, but he don't take the place of Cheryl. But there's nothing like the woman in the relationship. Because she does have a heart. A heart for a household, a heart to help those who are in need. That her husband does not. That's not saying that he don't have a compassion or a heart to give, but he's just not motivated like she is to do that. She brings integrity and character to her husband. She makes him look good. Her values and honor and wisdom and kindness and devotions are of the Lord. It triumphs over her charisma and physical beauty. In verses 25 and 29, the Word of God teaches us. In verse 25, strength and honor are her clothing, and she shall rejoice in time to come. She opens her mouth with, and her tongue is the law. That means that she speaks kind words. Hello, and listen to what it says. She opens her mouth with wisdom, and her tongue is of the law of kindness. She looketh well to her ways of her household, and eateth not bread of alanness. And her children arise up and call her blessed, her husband also, and he praises her. Many daughters have done virtuously, but there excels them all. Favor is deceitful, beauty is vain, but a woman that feareth the Lord, who trusteth in the Lord, shall be praised above all. Listen, guys. It ain't always on the outside. It's what's on the inside that counts. Let me tell you, if she's pretty on the inside, she's pretty on the outside. Even though she may have shaded three or four times, amen, from gray to yellow, amen, I don't know. But amen, she's beautiful on the outside. And see, it don't matter what this body is going to look like, because see, when Cheryl married me, I was a handsome fella. I was skinny as a rail. I didn't weigh no more than 165 soaking wet. Sam was talking about his britches size the other day, or Wednesday night or Sunday morning, whatever it was. Wednesday night. I wore 32s. 31. 30 is the first time when we met was 30. 30. 28 and 30. Now, something happened. Forty-six. I think it's them Chinese britches we've been importing. But something happened. I don't have my hair like I used to. Didn't have much then, but I did have a little bit. And, it, you know, what little bit I had, I did soak it down like John does, you know, with some stuff, you know. I tried to make it look good, but it would come down in my eyes. And when she was cutting her eyes at me, I was playing the bass in the church. I can play. Hello? And I would see her look at me. She'd give me a grin. And I said, woo! Huh? You know? It's something about a musician that catches a woman's eye, you know. And every time I catch eyes, she kept looking at me. I knew she was looking at me, but when my eye made contact with her eye, she, you know, she dug down. And she quit ducking after a while. Isn't it sweet? You never know what the Lord is doing. And bless her heart, she sought the Lord. He brought her to me because he knew I need help. God looked at her. He said, you need a lot of help, so I'm going to give you a reverend. I got a dog. I got a dog. All else fail, call the dog. Y'all, they don't never go to a church and be like this, amen, in another other church, amen. I guarantee you, ain't no other preacher's going to do what I'm doing today, amen. Let me tell you, God has a way to put things together. And when he puts it together, it don't matter, amen. If you get bald and fat. But no matter how many bottles you buy and shade your hair, amen, or how much Mary Kay you put on. See, if you got God in your heart, he's got God in his heart. You are beautiful to him regardless of what you put on. Or God, regardless of how you look, you are still beautiful. and made a good time, just look at her and said, "Baby, you're beautiful. Baby, you're beautiful."